Good morning students, welcome to the second term of history subject. Today we are going to study lesson number 6, empowerment of women and other weaker sections. Refer to textbook page number 31. In this particular lesson we are going to study the women's, they have participated in the freedom struggle and they have made an important contribution in the fields in the post-independence period, and the gender-based discrimination still exists. Especially the women from the scheduled castes, scheduled tribes, nomadic tribes and denotified tribes were the weaker sections of the Indian society. And we can see that according to the table which is given on page number 31, the number of the women per 1000 men, they have decreased to a certain extent. And the root cause of the problems of the women is because of the male-centric mentality of the men. Now let us learn about the Bhudan movement. Vinoba Bhave made use of the woman power in the Bhudan movement, which he started by understanding the Gandhiji's philosophy. Women volunteers, they carried the message of Bhudan to all the parts of the India. Actually, the women from the Telangana peasants' armed struggle, they played an important role and they challenged the rule of the Nizams and the feudal system. Because of their struggle, the region became free from bonded labor, and the women were also got freedom from this particular torment. Now let us learn about the manifestation of women power. Now, especially women have to face the burnt of the scarcity of the supplies and rising prices, which gave strength to a separate organization in 1972. Under the leadership of the socialist leader Mrinal Gore, the women in Mumbai, they participated in demonstration which was been called as Latne Morcha, that what it means, rolling pin demonstration. Actually what happened, oil, ghee, rava, maida, they became very scarce as the Diwali was approaching very close by, and kerosene also, the prices of the kerosene had been increased. Therefore the women, they came together and they started to started a revolt against this particular rise in the prices. Therefore this movement was been met with a success, and the public got a glimpse of the united power of the women. Now let us learn about the Chipko movement. Now the Chipko movement was started in 1973 in the forest region of the foothills of the Himalayas, which shows the woman power. Now this movement was led by Chandi Prasad Bhatt and Sundar Lal Bahuguna. Gora Devi, she created awareness among the women with the help of Sudesha Devi and Bachchani Devi. Now here what the women did, they followed the strategy of holding hands and they were embracing each tree. As this method, it consisted of protecting the tree by embracing it. The movement came to an end and it was called as the Chipko movement. Now let us learn about the anti-liquor movement. Liquor, as we know, that it spoils the whole family if the person gets addicted to the liquor. Now in 1992 in Andhra Pradesh, what happened, a movement against this drinking of liquor started. It got a good response in the other states too. Now what happens if the head of the household, he dies due to the addiction to the alcohol, what happens, a full family suffers, and mostly the women have to suffer a lot. Now due to the alcoholism, what happens, they have to live in an extremely poverty and sorrow. Therefore, the movement got the support of the anti-arak movement in Andhra Pradesh. Arak means what? The local produced alcohol. Now, as a result, what happened? The government started a policy against this arak dealers. They set up a liquor shop in every town and villages. So, what happened? The poor laborers, what they used to get? They used to work hard in the day, and at night they used to get addicted to this alcohol. At the same time, what happened, a literacy program was been also run in the village of the state. The Sita Mata Katha was narrated as the past as a part of this particular program. In this story, it was been told about the Sita who creates awareness among the people of the village and gets alcohol to be banned from the village. Then a major U-turn took place in 1992 where three youths of the Dubughanta village of Nellore district in Andhra Pradesh drowned in a lake in a state of inebriation and they died. Therefore, the women came together, they got very angry and they forced the closure of the arak shop. Arak means liquor shop. This report of this particular news in the local newspaper, it got affected in many villages. Its effect could be seen in other villages too. Therefore, this movement spread to the entire state and the government had to make a strict policy against the sale of the alcohol. Now, let us study about the International Women's Year. Now, as we all know that the United Nations has declared 1975 as the International Women's Year. Now, in this, three main aspects of this program was peace, development and equality between whom? Men and women. Therefore, in 1975, the government of India, they appointed Dr. Full Renu Guha as its chairman. And this particular committee, they made a survey or a detailed survey was been done related to the women's issue, related to the social position of women, their status. Then the consequences of the constitutional, that the law provisions made for the women. And also the education of women and its percentage. Then their progress due to the education. Then the difficulties faced by the working women. The position of the women with the respect to work, livelihood. Then their wages as compared to the men's wages. The female-male ratio, birth and mortality rates and the role of the women. Taking into the consideration, a statewide conference or we can say that a meeting was being organized for the women and it was being held in 1975, which was being organized by Stri Mukti Sangharsh Samiti. Women's year from all walks of life, they participated in this particular conference. Then the Samiti published its manifesto or issue in 1978. Now, the policy of a struggle against discrimination on the basis of gender, caste and varna was been adopted. Therefore, this gave rise to the collection of the songs, which was been called as Stri Mukti Chi Lalkari, a street play called Mulgi Zali O by Jyoti Mapsekar, and a periodical called Prerak Lalkari, which became a mouthpiece and such other programs was been organized. Similarly, in 1977, groups like the Sri Mukti Andolan Samiti established by Sodamani Rao in Pune, then Bayaja, a fortnightly, it is a magazine, and a Sri Uvach Maitrin, Sri Anyai Viruddha Manch in Aurangabad, Mahila Dakshat Samiti in Kolhapur, Mahila Hakka in Nasik, and Nari Pramodan Manch in Latur, they were being formed. Then anti-dowry protection committee was also being formed all over the Maharashtra. Then a conference or a meeting was being held to protest against the operation of women's, which was being organized in Dhule city. Vidya Bal's periodicals, then Nari Samta Manch and Minun Saryajanani also worked for the Samajwadi Mahila Sabha. And the Krantikari Mahila Sanghatna were a great help in dealing with the women's issue. Now, the employment guarantee scheme in Maharashtra also helped to empower the women. We can see that Pramila Danvante, she established Mahila Dakshata Samiti in Delhi. In which year? In 1976. Now, many of the branches opened in other states also. Like you can see in Andhra Pradesh, Tamil Nadu, Kerala, Odisha, Madhya Pradesh, Uttar Pradesh and Punjab. The Communist Party, also one of the party, it established the Akhil Bharatiya Janwadi Mahila Sanghatna in 1980. Then efforts were being made to start branches of this organization also all over the parts of India. Now what this Sanghatna started to do? They started to struggle against the issues like dowry, female forticides, domestic abuse. Then research on the women's issues were also undertaken at the various levels. Women's Study Center, it was been started at the first women's university, the Srimati Nathibai Damodar Thakarse SNDT Women's University Mumbai and at Tata Institute of Social Sciences Mumbai. सावित्रीबाई फुले पुणे यूनिवर्सिटी एंड शिवाजी यूनिवर्सिटी कोल्हापूर. नाउ दिस सेंटर्स दे प्लेड अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट रोल इन डेवलपिंग द विजन ऑन वुमेन्स इश्यूज. नाउ लेट अस लर्न सम ऑफ द लॉज फॉर द वुमेन्स. द हिंदू कोड बिल दैट इज 1956, इट गेव द राइट टू द वुमेन टू एलिमनी. एलिमनी मीन्स वॉट? आफ्टर द डिवोर्स द हजबेंड हैज टू पे अ सर्टन अमाउंट ऑफ मनी टू द वाइफ पर मंथ एंड देयर शेयर इन द फादर्स प्रॉपर्टी. वुमेन्स राइट टू सीडन वॉज ऑल्सो बीन रिकोगनाइज. पॉलीगैमी, पॉलीगैमी मीन्स वॉट? अ वुमेन हु हैज मोर देन वन वाइफ वॉज बीन मेड इलीगल एंड वुमेन्स ऑल्सो गॉट राइट्स जस्ट लाइक मैन टू गेट डाइवर्स. प्रिवेंशन ऑफ डाउरी एक्ट ऑफ 1961 मेड बोथ गिविंग एंड टेकिंग अ डाउरी अ क्रिमिनल ऑफेंस. देयरफॉर दिस डिसमेंटल्ड द डाउरी ट्रेडिशन बाय द रूट्स एंड फर्दर इट एनकरेज इन टू द सोशल मूवमेंट्स एंड इट गेव राइज दैट डाउरी शुड नॉट बी टेकन बाय बोथ द पार्टीज. Now the law alleviated the distress to women caused by the undesirable tradition of the dowry. The law also gave maternity benefit act to the women to get leave from work at the time of the child birth, which also came into the force in 1961. Now let us learn awareness against the dowry tradition. Even after the enactment of the anti-dowry law, we can see many incidents was been faced. Like in the newspaper, it was always coming. Women were burning to death as sari pallu catches fire while cooking. Or what happens, a woman slips into well while washing clothes, drowns and dies. Such report was been published in newspaper. Investigation showed that most of the frequent cause of such death was due to dowry. Therefore, it was a very important role of the police and the administration and judiciary, that is court. They had to play a major role to protect the women rights. This created a greater awareness. Therefore, the Dowry Prohibition Amendment Act came into the force in 1984. Then in 1988, we can see that 2209 women, they died due to dowry tradition. Then in 1990, the number of the dowry deaths, it increased to 4835. Then in 1993, it again increased to 5377. And this numbers will show us that this issue of the women should be seriously taken and the women's right should be protected. I hope you must have understood this lesson up till here. In the next lecture, we'll see about the family code. I hope you must have understood it. If you have any query, kindly contact.